Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here, and welcome to the channel. Today we're going to look at how to fly a raw data ILS approach. This is something that's part of the Airbus type rating, and it's often something that's tested when you get a new job at an airline, for example. And it tests your ability to interpret the data from the primary flight display, and also your instrument flying and your handling of the aircraft. So it's a good check, and a good one to keep your skills sharp. It basically, in terms of real-life application, degradation of system may force us, so example, an autopilot malfunction may mean that we have to manually take over control of a instrument's ILS approach. So that's where it may be used. So to fly the raw data approach, we've obviously got our localizer information displayed. You can see the glideslope's just become active. Currently got the simulator pause here. We're set up for runway 07 at London Luton inside the Fenix mod, Microsoft Flight Simulator. And we're going to shortly disconnect the autopilots and manually fly the aircraft using what's known as the bird. So to fly a raw data ILS approach, we need to take the flight directors out. I have a key binding which takes both of them out, which is very useful, and one I think you should have in the simulator when you're single crewed, because in a TCAS resolution advisory, you need to take both flight directors off quickly. There's never a film on that, but available, but in the series. But I've got taking the flight directors off with my key binding, and you see the green thrust bars have gone from the display. And we can fly a raw data ILS approach just like this, and just aligning our diamonds with these yellow bars. I keep centralized and fly a stable approach. But another tool we have on the Airbus is track FPA mode. So currently we're in heading vertical speed. Heading is the direction the nose is facing and is influenced by the wind. So we can be flying heading 140. But our path across the ground may be different because of the wind affecting the aircraft. If we select track FPA mode, so we fly a track across the ground where it is corrected for wind, so we'd maintain a constant track across the ground, so we're constantly adjusting for the wind when we're flying on track mode. So particularly useful, obviously we're flying towards a runway today, we need to be lined up, so we want to be in track mode for that. With track mode, we get what we call the bird on the Airbus, now displayed on the primary flight display. That's a very useful tool for us, and one we'd often use perhaps when flying visually as well. You'd see I did some visual circuits not so long ago on stream, and we're flying with the bird at that point as well. So when the wings of the bird are level with the white line of the horizon, we should be at vertical speed zero. When the belly of the aircraft is here on the 5 degree mark, because we haven't got a 3 degree marking, the aircraft will be flying 3 degrees down there or thereabouts. So that's useful to know, because our localizer here is 3 degrees, and 3 degrees is pretty standard for an ILS. They're not all the same, so do check and know your glideslope angle. And 140 knots, we're looking for 743 feet per minute descent rate. As a bit of a reference there, obviously we're not going to be exactly 140 knots today, but that's the closest one to what we're going to be doing. So 700 to 800 feet per minute on the vertical scale is what we'll be looking for. So looking for very small inputs, obviously the Airbus is also equipped with a fantastic tool, which is its auto trim. So if we were to, example, level the wings up on the horizon, we should be able to let go of the side stick. The aircraft will auto trim into that position and it should stay there. So we sort of point it where we want to go and let go, but small movements are flying this, don't oversteer. Up, down, left, right, whatever you want, but very small inputs. Small progressive inputs. So what I'm going to do now is disengage the autopilot, and I'll put in the runway track of 074, which will move this little green bar. So this green bar here represents our track. We can, once we're lined up with the localizer, then get coordinated by lining the tail of the aircraft up to the track, so we're flying the correct track towards the runway once we've intercepted it, the localizer diamond. So I'll do that now. I'll get the simulator unpaused. I'm going to disengage the autopilot, my control, and using my mini FCU, I will put track 074 in, and we'll see shortly that the Diamond there is going to come alive. There we go. I'm going to start turning inbound. Quite a sharp angle, so we may overshoot slightly, but we can pick it up from the other direction. Bit of nose down in that sharp turn, because the aircraft will balloon up. There's our inbound track, so I'm going to come over the other side of it now to re-intercept the localizer. The altitude there. At this point we'll go flaps 2, speed checks flaps 2, and we'll go gear down. As we get to about half dot there, we want to start putting the belly of that bird onto the 5 degrees. About now, work a little bit ahead. Flaps 3, speed checks, flaps 3. A little bit to the left. Small adjustments all the time. The aircraft going down, and flaps 4, speed checks, flaps 4. Get ascent going. Looting with the flaps full there, so we should be able to counteract that. That's something you wouldn't normally experience to see if you're flying it on autopilot. So watch the ballooning on the flaps, and in turns check. Landing checklist: missed approach altitude 3,000, set cabin secure. ECAM memo: landing and no blue. Approach lights just coming in now. Lost again in the cloud.
500.
Back on the instruments, there they are again. Murky old day here. Continue. Reverse spoilers, decel, 70 knots, manual braking. Very poor braking performance today. So that is the raw data ILS. One to have a play with. It's depending on your wind situation, not the easiest, but you do practice it. It's a great one to sort of practice your instrument flying and hand flying at the same time, sort of, you know, that coordination. So it's a really good one to do. Any questions on that, please drop them in chat. Please like and subscribe, and if you really want to, please buy me a coffee through the buy me coffee link in the video description. It'd be appreciated. Thanks for watching.